revitalization of agricultural extension system, policy framework for agricultural extension. Reforming the public sector extension is the goal, promoting the private sector to effectively complement, supplement, and wherever possible to substitute the public extension system, the attempt is being made. Augmenting media and information technology support for extension is another area that demands our attention. Mainstreaming the gender concerns is also a matter of priority. When we look at the historical perspectives, we all started with 1947 Food Minister's idea that Grow More Food campaign was the vital need. Then in 1948, we started with a pilot project in the Etawah district of Uttar Pradesh, pioneered by Albert Mayer. In 1952, community development programs were started, and in 1953, the National Extension Service was initiated. Then India's food crisis and steps to meet it was an important landmark report or recommendation given by a team of Ford Foundation sponsored group in the year 1959. They combined the technical know-how and concentrating on the manpower and resources in the selected areas. Then beginning of the intensive agriculture district program also started. Later, we introduced on a pilot basis what is called a training and visit system in the Chambal command area of Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh during the year 1974-75, and it was a very important landmark in the extension systems. It was extended to 17 other states in 1978-79. Under the training and visit system, village extension worker, otherwise called VEO, became the most important link. 10% of the farmers under the TNE system were identified as a group and as contact farmers. Village extension workers visit the contact farmers according to a well-planned schedule covering 8 groups of villages at least once in a week or a fortnight. Then one day fortnightly training was also arranged. Out of 12 days in a fortnight, a village extension worker would spend 8 days in the field, 2 days in the training, and 2 days for clearing the pending work. The strengths of TNE system included the close research and extension linkage, then buildup of technical skills of subject matter specialists regularly, then the researchers and subject matter specialists discuss and formulate relevant production recommendations. And of course, there were many constraints in the implementation of the training and visit system. The first one was it hasn't created uniform impact. It did not give due emphasis to other enterprises such as animal husbandry, fisheries, horticulture, etc. Then similarly, there was no visible impact on the rain-fed crops like millets, pulses and oil seeds. In addition to this, some of the constraints felt were the multiplicity of public extension system, narrow focus of the agricultural extension system, lack of farmer involvement in program planning, lack of local capacity to validate and refine technologies, and the absence of public sector linkages with the private sector. Then in the post-training and visit extension system era, there were some constraints experienced like lack of transparency and accountability, inadequate technical capacity among the extension functionaries, supply-driven rather than market-driven extension. Then the extension reforms were introduced during 2005 and 2006 by the Department of Agriculture and Cooperation under the Ministry of Agriculture, Government of India. An important landmark reformation is Agriculture Technology Management Agency, designed for the district level and pilot tested under innovations in technology dissemination component of NAIP. The key features of reforms include new institutional arrangements for decentralized decision making, convergence of the departments as a gap filling mode, multi-agency extension strategies to encourage private sector with minimum 10% allocation, then group approach to extension through farmers organizations and commodity interest groups, then gender concern allocating at least 30% minimum, then the sustainability of extension services with a minimum of 10% of beneficiaries. Another salient feature of ATMA, our Agriculture Technology Management Agency, is unique district level autonomous institution created. Local research and extension priorities are set through strategic research and extension plans, otherwise called SREPs, then registered under the Societies of Registration Act of Government of India. There are many salient features of the ATMA, our Agriculture Technology Management Agency. The first one is the governing board that determines the program priorities and assesses the program impact. Then the executive head of the Agriculture Technology Management Agency is known as the project director, and a state level agriculture management extension training institute has been established in each state called SEMETI. Then another landmark in the reform era is the National Commission on Farmers. This aimed at promoting the commodity based farmers organizations. Then it tried to forge the research, extension, education, farmer and market linkages. Then form schools to farmer learning in the fields of outstanding farmers, awardees and well recognized farmers in the country. Then the 11th plan approach paper, there were many thrust areas like revitalization of extension system focusing on known technologies, improvement of research and extension linkages, then convergence of schemes of Ministry of Agriculture. Then under the 12th plan, there are many strategies for extension like rural transformation, then Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act, National Rural Livelihood Mission, National Rural Drinking Water Program under Total Sanitation Campaign, Integrated Watershed Development Program, Pradhan Mantri Gramin Sadak Yojana. So now we will see what are the important features of some of the schemes generated, like MGNREA. It generates employment, it provides technical soundness of design and quality of works undertaken that could ensure land productivity enhancement. Then technical capacity at the local level had to be significantly enhanced. The National Rural Livelihood Mission was successful if it is tied up with livelihood programs such as improved agriculture, dairying, marketing, etc. This has been recognized well and taken up under this mission. Then distinctive focus on federations of self-help groups that became powerful units of economic empowerment was also attempted. Then Indira Awas Yojana, this is to transform into a larger habitat development program by ensuring domestic water, sanitation, clean fuel and electricity with housing. Then integrated watershed management program, its emphasis was on livelihoods, especially for families without any assets. Then National Rainfed Areas Authority could play a major anchoring role in the infusing of integrated watershed management program. Then water management was another important area. Command area development and the rehabilitation and physical modernization of existing major irrigation system was given the maximum attention. Extensive rainwater harvesting assisted by spaced based maps and active ground truthing and convergence with other development schemes was also aimed at. Then there was a move towards sprinkler and drip irrigation and taking it away from flood irrigation. Then there is an assuring irrigation to such more lands far beyond the present 42% of arable land in the country. Then strengthening of the drinking water resources was also a focus. Under the soil nutrient management, adoption of farming systems approach with the livestock and the common lands was attempted. Generation of biomass for bulk addition of organic matter in the soil to maintain proper soil health was a matter of focus. In situ degeneration of biomass through sole cropping or intercropping or bunt cropping of green menu crops was also attempted. Then Producing and encouraging the use of soil biofertilizers was also considered for soil nutrient management. Crop rotations were focused to enrich soil, then pooling of existing soil testing data into a system of soil nutrition management was aimed at. Then the extension reforms through the Agriculture Technology Management Agency, there was a need to better integrate into the ATMOS the problem solving capacities of KVKs and the feedback loop these offer to state agriculture universities and national agriculture research system. Thank you.